the world of insects, high risk of attack has led to the development of camouflage as a means for survival, especially in the larval stage. One caterpillar may look like a stick, while another disguises itself as bird droppings. Though crypsis may have its advantages, researchers uncovered some of the most extensive evidence of caterpillars using another strategy. Previously best known in adult butterflies, mimicry. Insects use a camouflage to protect themselves by looking like inanimate or inedible objects. Mimicry, however, involves one species evolving similar warning color patterns to another. It is one of the best and earliest studied examples of natural selection. This can help us learn where evolutionary adaptations come from. Bright warning coloration has evolved in many insects with physical or chemical defenses, and further research into how insects metabolize plant toxins for their own benefit has potential use in the medical field. The way caterpillars can detoxify a plant's poisonous chemicals and resynthesize them for their own chemical defense or for pheromones has been an interest for researchers for years. We can look at the caterpillar's metabolic systems to understand how they deal with secondary plant compounds, the toxic plant substances used for centuries as tonics, spices, medicine, and recreational drugs. Based on the number of eggs laid by a single female butterfly, survival tactics would include sharp spines, toxic chemicals, and hairs accompanied by bright warning coloration. It is estimated about 99% of caterpillars die before reaching the pupal stage. Aptly known as the snake mimic caterpillar, what you're looking at is the early life stage of a rather inconspicuous moth in the family Sphingidae. When disturbed, this larva expands the first body segments, mimicking a snake head with black eyes and even light reflections. It's no easy maneuver. First, the caterpillar must throw itself backwards and twist to reveal its underside, where hidden shades of yellow, white, and black are found. Once in position, air is pumped to this portion of the body, drawn by way of tiny holes in the caterpillar's sides. As the segments inflate, the caterpillar is truly transformed, now topped by a diamond-shaped face resembling that of many venomous snake species. They act almost like parasites, because the mimics are actually edible and therefore deceive predators without having to invest in costly attempts. Such a system can only be stable when the mimics are relatively rare. Otherwise, predators will learn the trick and attack more individuals of the mimics. Mimicry may be relatively rare in caterpillars because it is more difficult for them to establish bright coloration. A brightly colored caterpillar has less chance of evading predators than a mobile adult butterfly or moth. In adults, bright coloration may be favored by sexual selection for signaling to males and females. Bright colors may be disadvantageous since they attract predators, but advantageous for attracting mates. Once established, bright colors might then be modified by natural selection for mimicry, another possible reason why mimicry seems to evolve much more frequently in adults than in caterpillars. However, it is believed that mimicry is more common in caterpillars than we realize, but may receive less attention because larvae must be raised to adulthood to identify mimicry complexes.